And so those are all the Rainbow Rock shorts. Now let's get into the shorts that led us into the Friendship Games. Starting with a banner day starring everyone's favorite waifu stealer, Flash Sentry. Plus those other two guys, I think they're called Microchips and Sandwood around the fandom. And while I did poke fun at Flash in this short at the beginning of this episode, I kind of like that he's there. He comes off as an arrogant jerk a bit in this, but that means he has a personality! You know, one that wasn't forced upon him by three magical creatures. And stupid song name aside, it's good to see they actually are following through in the whole guitar player thing, and he does want his band to take off. Plus, his quibbling with the other two led to some great comedic moments.
You're harshing the flow.
Hey, you did that on purpose! My friendship algorithm!
Hey, you just projectile science all over my chorus!
It also led to this.
Watch the hair, man!
Okay, while I haven't said it in a video, I have made jokes elsewhere that Flash, with his spiky hair and pretty boy looks and dull personality involved with Twilight, could maybe be a parody of Edward Cullen. But then they actually put sparkles on him. I don't know whether to be amused or terrified. Eh, well, I guess I'll take comfort in knowing he pretty much has to do slave labor for Vice Principal Luna. And the next one is All's Fair in Love and Friendship Games, starring our favorite pair of best friends.
And then I said, it tastes like marshmallows? Yes, so that made me feel like you were on a camping trip?
Yes, just like that time we went to the amusement park in 8th grade!
You know me so well.
You know me so well.
Yep, they're going for that right off the bat. And being such best friends, I'm sure their entries into the friendship game against each other will be nice and calm and respectful and... Well, that escalated quickly. Though, to be fair, their tryouts do start out pretty normally, with Lyra doing a little dance number and Bon Bon showing off her sweet Zatanna cosplay. But then... INSANITY HAPPENS! Okay, that last bit really is my favorite of the whole thing. And also, Kill la Kill reference. Again, for kids. But of course, we all knew they were both going to get on the team, and so we end our short with...
Best friends forever!
Okay, you're not even trying to be subtle anymore! Speaking of unsubtle insanity, let's talk about Photo Finished. Especially with how creepy this title card is! It should be a simple premise where Luna asks Photo Finished to get pictures for the yearbook. But again... we go the crazy route.
Stop! Horses pose!
God, you are starving! Now take a bite! No! Do not bite it! Yes! Yes! No! No! Enough! I go! Sports!
Like a graceful gazelle, you are striving to place the orb of desire in the net of your future. Enough! I go. Yes, read! You are so very intrigued by that story. No, no, that book is out of order. It does not comply with the Dewey Decimal System.
Shh!
Enough!
I go.
Destroy me now, yeah! Destroy me, yeah! Give it!
Funny thing is, way back in Season 1 when Photo Finish was introduced, at least her pony version, was a little more calm about her picture taking.
Yes! Show Photo Finish something! No!
Yes!
So I'm not really sure what happened there, but I'll give her this, she's right. Her work speaks for itself.
Photo finish lets her work speak for itself. These are really impressive.
Also, I love how these two seem to have stopped questioning this a long time ago and just accepted their lot in life. Well, the crazy train just keeps rolling along with Pinkie Spy. The only one of these shorts to actually feature Crystal Prep students, kind of. Rainbow was trying to spy on the competition, and of course Pinkie happened to be there, because why not? And I do love all the outfits she brought for the spy mission.
Cat burglar! Dog burglar! Tree! Body suit! Camouflage!
That's like the opposite of camouflage!
I don't know, she could fit right in with the G2 Combaticons. Also, this happened.
You smell like vanilla.
Yeah, that's weird even for Pinkie. I mean, I'm pretty sure that's just pure shipping fuel. Maybe they should have focused less on teasing shippers and more on their production values, because look, there's a boom mic right there! That's just shoddy workmanship. I do love, by the end, the, I don't know what's going on looks from all the Crystal Prep students when Rainbow and Pinkie are found out. Alright, let's bring this home with the Science of Magic, the only short to feature all of the main six this time around. Actually, I meant main seven, because Sunset's there! Yay! And she's trying to figure out how their magic works in this world. And I immediately have questions like, where did she get that equipment? And how did she get it into the music room? And also, why does a high school music room have what appears to be a sound booth? I think I used the sell I have so many questions meme a little too early. That aside though, I do have to say Sunset's looking mighty nice in that lab coat. Shut up! Just shut up, okay? It's not my fault they make her look so attractive! Stop judging me! Anyway, we get a fun montage of Sunset basically being assaulted by all the others' cutie marks. Except for Rarities. All that happens is this. My guess would be because they didn't want her impaled by thousands of diamond shards. Instead, we get whatever this is. Yeah, I'm sorry, there's no way that doesn't look really, really wrong. So after enduring all these indignities, what does Sunset come up with?
I have no idea how magic works in this world.
That's okay, Sunset. Neither do the writers. And those are all the shorts between the two last Equestria Girls movies. And maybe all the shorts we'll get? There seems to be some question about if Legend of Everfree will have them. I hope they do, because these things are just a fun little build-up to the movie proper, and offer some great little character moments. But I guess we'll just have to wait and see. For now, I'm going to go back to Rainbow Rocks, because I realized I barely touched upon the Dazzlings in that review. So join me next time when I talk about these three lethal ladies in my next review on... Well, that's just bad timing.